So let us start with the normal distribution, a very important distribution. It is a type of continuous distribution as we had discussed in the first lecture of theoretical distribution. But before starting with actual properties of the normal distribution, there are some important conditions that we should know. So I would be giving you all the conditions. You can take it down along with me. Number one, it is a symmetrical bell-shaped curve which extends on both sides to infinity without touching the horizontal line. The curve is something like this. See, if you observe the curve from the topmost point, if I draw a perpendicular line like this, then in that case this part and this part, they both are exactly equal to each other. So the central point over here, this value over there is of mu, which is the mean of that particular distribution, and the horizontal line is for the values of x. The curve is representing the frequency values which are taken by x, and hence it is called as a frequency distribution. You can say it is a symmetrical frequency distribution for the reason that in case from this horizontal vertical line, vertical line, if I fold this particular curve, it will overlap exactly on both the sides. When I say overlap, matlab area to the left and area to the right, they both are exactly equal, and the curve is not at all touching the horizontal line, but it can go from negative infinity to positive infinity, any value over there. Now there are some more important points that we need to know under this. That was our just point number one. After that, point number two is that all three averages are equal for the normal distribution. Now, what is the meaning of the three averages? It means that mean is equal to median is equal to mode. So this central value can be equal to mean, or it can be equal to median, or it can also be equal to the value of mode of that particular distribution. The point number three, as I already told you, the central vertical line divides the curve into exactly two equal parts. number 4. Area between minus infinity and mu is exactly equal to area between mu and infinity. Now, as we all have studied in our previous chapter, that is the probability, that total probability is always equal to 1. So, from minus infinity to positive infinity, if the area is equal to 1, and if the vertical line divides it into exactly two equal parts, it means this is 0.5 and this is also 0.5. So area between minus infinity to mu and area between mu to infinity, these both are exactly equal to 0.5. That is the point number 4. Point number 5, we say that quartiles are always equidistant from all three averages. Obviously, in case of normal distribution, when all the three averages are being represented by the same central point over here, so when I talk about quartiles, it can be like this. See, this. So this distance and this distance, this is exactly equal to each other. Now in quartiles, we have seen that the middle value, which is the median, can also be called as the second quartile. So the first value will be obviously my first quartile, and the third value will be my third quartile. So in this case, these both distances are exactly equal to each other. Hence, we say that the condition is that quartiles are always equidistant from all the three averages. That is mean, median, and mode. That is your point number 5. Point number 6 is based on the standard normal variable. I will give you the formula for this particular standard normal variable as of now, but actually it will be applied in the numerical examples. So we will see how to apply this in the numericals later on. For now, we will just see the condition and how we represent the standard normal distribution. Okay. The condition for the standard normal distribution is that mu, that is the mean, is always equal to 0, and variance, which is notation is sigma square, is always equal to 1. This is the basic condition that I require for the standard normal variable. Okay, and how do we represent that? It is given by z is equal to x minus mu by sigma. This formula, z is equal to x minus mu by sigma, will be used later on when we are solving our numericals, but for now, as we are writing all the points and conditions, so better we write everything together. So these are all the important conditions that you require for the normal distribution, the basic idea about your normal distribution. Now further, the next thing that we are going to see is the properties of the normal distribution. Yes, give the next heading everybody. Properties of normal distribution. error point number one, obviously, as usual, type it is a continuous distribution. Point number two, parameters mean mu and variance sigma square. So I can see that there are two parameters. It means it is biparametric continuous distribution. If you remember this word biparametric, we are also seen in one more type of distribution, which was binomial distribution. Over there the parameters were n and p, but binomial distribution is actually a biparametric discrete distribution. Normal distribution is the biparametric continuous distribution. So you have to read the question, your MCQ, carefully, and depending on that you have to decide whether the question is asking us about the discrete distribution or the continuous distribution. If they ask you about the discrete, we will go for binomial. If they ask for continuous, we will select the normal distribution as the biparametric distribution. After that, the point number three, the formula fx is equal to 1 upon sigma root 2 pi e to the power minus 1 upon 2 x minus mu upon sigma the whole square. Otherwise it is also equal to 1 upon sigma root 2 pi e raised to minus half x minus mu the whole square divided by sigma square. Now over here I have to remember one very important thing, that x can be from negative infinity to positive infinity, any value. If you remember, I had told you in binomial distribution, x is from 0, 1, 2 up till n. In case of Poisson distribution, I had told you that x is 0, 1, 2 and so on. It means that here there are only whole number of values, therefore we write the number 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, because these are both actually discrete distributions. But because it is a continuous distribution, we write the range for the value of x, that it is from minus infinity to positive infinity, any value. It can take decimals, it can take fractions, it can take whole numbers, it can take negative numbers, it can take positive numbers, it can take any kind of possible value for x. Therefore, it is most universally widely accepted distribution for statistics. Point number four, points of inflection. Now, before seeing the actual values of points of inflection, first thing that I want you to know is what exactly is the meaning of point of inflection. So I'll write the small definition for that. You can copy it down along with me. Those points on the curve where the curve changes from concave to convex and back from convex to concave. Is called points of inflection. Now, I'm sure you won't understand directly like this. I'll show you the diagram for that. Suppose if this kind of normal curve that we are having, symmetrical curve, if you observe this point over here, till here there is one shape of the normal curve. We can say it is the concave curve. Again, from this point over here, it is again changing the shape. But in between, it is having a convex shape. So these points on the number line, from this point I draw a perpendicular to the number line. So this point and this point over here, these are the two points of inflection over here. Okay, and the distance between these two points is of sigma. So this is also sigma and this is also sigma. And as I had told you in the previous point that the central point over here is always mu. Therefore, the lower point or the left point is actually mu minus sigma and the upper point or the right point is actually mu plus sigma. Now this is what we are talking about, the normal distribution. Now we are having two different distributions over here. As I have told you, one is normal and the another is the standard normal. So let us see for both of them what is the difference. So just understand very carefully. For normal variable, points of inflection are mu minus sigma and mu plus sigma. For standard normal variable, points of inflection. Now see guys very carefully. For standard normal, I told you some time back that mu is equal to 0 and sigma is equal to 1. So when I take over here, 0 minus 1 is actually minus 1 and 0 plus 1 is actually just equal to 1. So for normal distribution, if the question is talking, you will take mu minus sigma and mu plus sigma. And if the question is talking about the standard normal distribution, you will take it as minus 1 and plus 1. Point number 5, which is based on the quartiles. Once again, when you talk for quartiles, there are two different things. One is for the normal distribution and the another is for the standard normal distribution. So carefully we have to observe the question and based on that we have to select our options of MCQs. So I'll give you the formula and the value for these quartiles. For the normal distribution, it is Q1 is equal to mu minus 0.675 sigma. Q3 is actually mu plus 0.675 sigma. This 0.675 positive and negative has got a certain derivation which is not in the scope of your syllabus. So we are not going into deriving these values, but we just have to remember these values by heart for our MCQ solving. Okay. So don't come under confusion ki from where does this come and why does this come. It just is the formula. जैसे आप लोग बाकी के फॉर्मूलाज याद रखते हो और बाकी के फॉर्मूलाज अप्लाई करते हो, वैसे ये फॉर्मूलाज भी अपने को अप्लाई करने. तो डोंट गो अंडर द थिंकिंग कि फ्रॉम वेयर इट इज कमिंग. इट इज जस्ट द फॉर्मूला दैट वी हैव टू बाय आउट फॉर Q1 एंड Q3. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर द नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. एंड वेन यू टॉक अबाउट द स्टैंडर्ड नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, Q1 and Q3. Now see, you know that mu is 0. So this will become 0 minus and 0 plus. You know that standard deviation is 1. So 0.675 into 1. And it is plus 0.675 into 1. So iska answer apne ko milega minus 0.675. Iska answer aapko milega positive 0.675. So these are the two values of quartiles for the standard normal distribution, whereas these are the two entire formulas that we have to remember in case of the actual normal distribution. Now after that we come to the next very important point under this itself, which is based on the quartile deviation. We had seen this in our dispersion chapter, and we say that it is given by Q3 minus Q1 upon 2. So when I want to calculate this for the normal distribution, how do we do that? Let us understand. Come on. Quartile deviation is equal to mu plus 0.675 sigma minus mu minus 0.675 sigma whole upon 2. Open the bracket, mu plus 0.675 sigma minus mu plus 0.675 sigma divided by positive mu, negative mu cancel over. So 0.675 plus 0.675 is actually twice of 0.675 sigma whole divided by 2. This 2 and 2 will go away. So apne ko answer milega quartile deviation ka 0.675 sigma in case of your normal distribution. But when we are talking for standard normal distribution, quartile deviation will be just directly obtained from here. Mu is anyway 0, so we don't need to worry about it. For standard normal distribution, I know that sigma value is equal to 1. So use this information. So 0.675 multiplied by 1. And hence I get quartile deviation for the standard normal distribution as 0.675. Very simple. Point number 6. It is based on mean deviation about. Now see, when you talk about mean deviation, there are three values of mean deviation. It can be about mean or median or mode. आपके क्वेश्चन में चाहे जो भी पूछा हो, यू शुड नेवर वरी अबाउट इट. सबका वैल्यू इक्वली होने वाला है. द सिंपल रीजन इज दैट मीन, मीडियन, मोड तीनों का वैल्यू हमेशा इक्वल होता है नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन के लिए. तो आपको कंफ्यूज करने के लिए वो बोल सकते हैं मीन डिविएशन अबाउट मीन, या तो फिर मीन डिविएशन अबाउट मीडियन, या तो मीन डिविएशन अबाउट मोड. बट आई वुड से डू नॉट वरी एट ऑल, ऑल द थ्री वैल्यूज आर ऑलवेज द सेम इन केस ऑफ नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. बाकी सब में सेम नहीं होता, लेकिन नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज वन विच हैज गॉट ऑल द थ्री वैल्यूज सेम, सो वी नीड नॉट वरी. द ओनली थिंग इज आपके क्वेश्चन में आपको ध्यान से देखना है कि वो नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन का बात कर रहा है कि स्टैंडर्ड नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन का बात कर रहा है. ओवर देयर यू हैव टू बी केयरफुल, अदरवाइज इट इज वेरी इजी फॉर अस. आई फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑब्वियसली गिव फॉर नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. Mean deviation is equal to 4 by 5 sigma, or mean deviation is equal to 0.8 into sigma, क्योंकि 4 upon 5 अगर आप डिवाइड करोगे तो आपको मिल जाएगा 0.8. सेम वे में for the standard normal distribution, 4 upon 5 multiplied by 1 is actually going to be the same number, 4 upon 5. Or probably you can take mean deviation according to the second formula, 0.8 into 1, which is again the same, which is 0.8. That is your point number 6. And now, next point, point number 7. It is based on the additive property of normal distribution. Okay, when we talk about the additive property, suppose if I consider there is a variable x which has got normal distribution mu 1 comma sigma square 1, and there is another variable y which has a normal distribution mu 2 and sigma square 2, then in such a case we say that x plus y has got normal distribution with mu 1 plus mu 2 sigma square 1 plus sigma square 2, and x minus y will have a normal distribution with mu 1 minus mu 2, but plus sigma square. Yaad rakhna, standard deviation can never be negative. Therefore, standard deviation mein subtraction kabhi nahi karte hain hum log. We will always add the numbers.
Now see guys, that is your actual normal curve or normal distribution curve jisko hum logo ne break kiya hua hai in some parts. The first part or this part is the central line which represents to the mu value. This distance is sigma. So mu plus sigma and mu minus sigma, that totally covers 34.13% of your total area under the curve. So if you take this together from this value till this value, it considers 68.28%. You have to remember these values, guys, exactly like this for selecting the values of your MCQ. That's why I am giving it till maximum precision value as much as possible. Same way, if I go further to the left or to the right, this becomes my further sigma values. So sigma and sigma, so these are twice of sigma on the left and twice of sigma to the right. Therefore, it is mu plus 2 sigma and mu minus 2 sigma. So if I go sigma units further, it is covering more 13.59% on the left as well as 13.59 to the right. So if I add these values as well as these values together, totally it will consider 95.46% of your normal distribution. And over here, when you add this 34.135 and 13.59, it will actually cover 47.725% to the right, as well as the same value 47.725 to the left hand side of mu. So these values are rarely asked, so that's why I did not write it before. But in case if you want to know, then you can just add the two values, 34.135 and 13.59. So you will get the required value as 47.6725 to the left as well as right. Now, when I move further sigma units to the right, it will give me mu plus 3 sigma, and sigma units to the left, then in that case, I'm sorry, I by mistakenly wrote this as mu plus, it has to be actually mu minus 3 sigma. And from mu minus 3 sigma to mu plus 3 sigma, totally it covers 99.73% of the total data. So when I know that between mu plus sigma and mu minus sigma, it covers 68.28%. Between mu minus sigma and mu plus, I should say 2 sigma in fact over here, it will cover 95.46%, and between mu minus 3 sigma and mu plus 3 sigma, it is covering 99.73% as I have written over here. So the leftover part, when I talk about leftover, so it is this region, this and this together, it is nothing but 100 minus 99.73, which is actually just 0.27% of the total data. As you can see, I have given the calculation to you over here.